After every war, you know, we always find out how unnecessary it was. And after this one, I'm sure all the generals will dash off and write books about the blunders made by other generals, and statesmen will publish their secret diaries, and it'll show, beyond any shadow of doubt, that war could easily have been avoided in the first place. And the rest of us, of course, will be left with the job of bandaging the wounded and burying the dead.
I don't trust people who make bitter reflections about war, Mrs. Barham. It's always the generals with the bloodiest records who are the first to shout what a hell it is. It's always the war widows who lead the Memorial Day parades.
That was unkind, Charlie, and very rude.
We shall never end wars, Mrs. Barham, by blaming it on ministers and generals or warmongering imperialists or all the other banal bogies. It's the rest of us who build statues to those generals and name boulevards after those ministers. The rest of us who make heroes of our dead and shrines of our battlefields. We wear our widow's weeds like nuns, Mrs. Barham, and perpetuate war by exalting its sacrifices. My brother died at Anzio.
I didn't know that, Charlie.
Yes, an everyday soldier's death, no special heroism involved. They buried what pieces they found of him. But my mother insists he died a brave death and pretends to be very proud.
You're very hard on your mother. Seems a harmless enough pretense to me.
No, Mrs. Barham. Now, you see, now my other brother can't wait to reach enlistment age. That'll be in September.
Oh, Lord.
Maybe ministers and generals who blunder us into wars, Mrs. Barham. The least the rest of us can do is to resist honoring the institution. What has my mother got for pretending bravery was admirable? She's under constant sedation and terrified she may wake up one morning, find her last son has run off to be brave. I don't think I was rude or unkind before, do you, Mrs. Barham?
Better push off, Emily, if you've got to get to work.
Give my best to Father, then.
Your father died in the Blitz, and your brother died a brave and pointless death in December 1940. I've carried on much too long with all this as it is.
Oh,
no, do go. Honestly, I'd much rather be alone. Really, I mean it. You're a kind man, Commander. I hope you'll come again.
Thank you, ma'am. I'd like to.